There are some rare finishers that you might not know about in Marvel Spider-Man. I will share multiple of them and also how you can trigger them. And there are some more interesting things to share, so let's get into it. If you enjoy that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go. It all started with Almar Hubby on Reddit, who shared this clip showcasing an awesome takedown that I don't think I've seen before. Well, many people agreed. But now the question is, of course, how do you do this awesome takedown? Well, it's based on the enemy and actually requires two focus bars instead of the regular one you need for most of the enemies in the game. The one from Almar Hubby is for the demon enemies with a sword, so not the regular ones with a smaller melee weapon. No, the sort of mini bosses that you first encounter in the villa with the lift shafts. I don't think there are any of these enemies in the demon bases in the game, and that's why I also think that many people, including me, never saw this move before. So just make sure that you have a two focus bars. The battle focus suit power, of course, can help with that. And then you should be able to finish this boss off with a cool special takedown. But there are actually more of these mini bosses that only go down with two focus bars and make you do a very cool, unique move. We got the new minigun enemies from the DLC that you take out by grabbing their gun and then kind of kicking it towards them. And I like this one actually even more, the finisher for the demon enemies with the whips. You also need two bars to instantly kill these enemies, and in this finisher you see Spidey like avoiding his attacks and then taking him out. A really cool one indeed. So yes, I totally think that the finisher for the demon sword enemies that Almar Hubby shared is the rarest, but I never really took a good look at how you can trigger these awesome unique attacks. So I think it's cool to be aware of that. I likely just kill these mini bosses with gadgets or regular attacks instead of my finisher. Well, now you can do these for yourself as well. Moving on to a funny thing that Nikesta on Reddit noted, namely that the bar with no name that we can of course visit in the Turf Wars DLC has UK plugs, while the game of course takes place in New York. So, not sure what happened here, but thought it was funny to share for sure. If you, by the way, enjoyed the soundtrack of The City That Never Sleeps, well, now you can listen to it on Spotify. So just search The City That Never Sleeps, and then you will be able to find it. I especially like the web launch and the Restoring Order track, so totally give that a listen if you want. Just a tip, and we got another really cool tip from SuperM7 on Reddit, who shows you how a jewelry store can be used to make a black background for your pictures. Really nice. And speaking of photos, at the end of every Spider-Man video, I of course take a look at the awesome pictures you send me. So let's take a look at that right now. You can send them over to my Twitter at YourRaptor with the hashtag SpiderRaptor, or via my Instagram YourRaptor as well. Follow me there and then share your shots. Just like Romero Dylan did on Instagram with a nice action shot of the Raimi suit with the feet in the air. Nice aperture. Really, really cool. The next one is also all about timing, with Spidey moving through a tight spot. And while we did not really see this animation a lot in the main story of the game, it was used more often in The City That Never Sleeps, especially in the Silver Lining one. And the screwball challenges for the photo bombs as well, if I remember correctly. Thanks for sharing, Ray Rish. Not sure who said the black suit was not in Marvel Spider-Man, because I got proof here from JTG16 with a shot in its face. Famous photomove booth that you of course go to early in the game with Jefferson Davis. Not weird that people went back to this spot with the Raimi suit to take some awesome shots like this one. And speaking of awesome shots, Joseph shared this picture of Spider-Man with an enormous shadow that makes him look twice as big, really nicely positioned, and I think it fits the awesome cover as well, so well done. The battle focus suit power takes over the suit in this shot from Tokyo Ghoul, but that does make it more of a standout. Some cool use of the frame as well to make it look like an action shot. Really, really nice. Of course, subscribe for everything Marvel Spider-Man and other upcoming PS4 games. I will cover it all here on the channel. Like this video to support the channel and check out my recent video on a suit power that was secretly changed by Insomniac, or a more general gaming video about big games that I think will be announced in 2019 with a lot of proof backing it up. I will speak to you next time and goodbye.